Linear regression was performed to determine if there is a linear relationship between hours of TV watched per day, which is X, and the number of sit-ups a person can do, which is Y. The results of the regression are shown here below. So this information would be on the computer screen or calculator screen after performing the linear regression. One of the most important things to pay close attention to is the form of the linear equation given here. Notice that A would be the y-intercept and B would be the slope of the line. So for our regression equation, notice that B, the slope of the line, would be negative 0.721 and A, or the y-intercept, would be 29.969. Which means our linear regression equation would be Y equals 29.969, and then since B is negative, we'll have minus 0.721 times X. Now we'll talk about R squared and R in just a moment, but our main question here is, use this linear model to predict the number of sit-ups a person who watches 2.5 hours of TV can do. And we're asked to round to the nearest tenths, which means round to one decimal place. So to make our prediction, we'll substitute 2.5 for X and determine Y. So we'd have Y equals 29.969 minus 0.721 times 2.5. Let's go and evaluate this on the calculator. So we'll have 29.969 minus 0.721 times 2.5. Running to the nearest tenth, this would be 28.2. Notice the 6 and the hundredths tells us to round up. So we'll say Y is approximately 28.2. So our prediction is 28.2 sit-ups if a person watches 2.5 hours of TV per night. Now if we go back to our information just for a moment, notice that R squared is equal to approximately 0.61 and R is approximately negative 0.78. Let's talk about what these are and what they tell us. R is called the correlation coefficient and it measures the strength and direction of a linear relationship between the two variables, or in our case, X and Y. And R is always between negative 1 and positive 1. The closer R is to negative 1, the stronger the negative correlation, which means as X increases, Y would decrease. And the closer R is to positive 1, the stronger the positive correlation, which would mean if X increases, then so does Y. So our value was approximately negative 0.78, so we have a negative correlation, but notice how it's not extremely strong because it's approximately negative 0.78. And then R squared is the coefficient of determination. R squared is a number between 0 and 1 used to describe how well the regression model fits the data. The closer R squared is to 1, the better the model fits the given data. And for our model, R squared is approximately 0.61, so this is not a great model, since this value is not extremely close to positive 1. I hope you found this example helpful.